Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Excel In-Depth Chapter 25, PowerPivot Relationships. Hey, Chapter 25 is all about PowerPivot, the great new add-in that came from Microsoft. PowerPivot lets us mash up various data sets. And so I have a couple of different tables here, sales and weather. One of those classical mashups. Let's see how the sales vary by weather. When we go over to PowerPivot, you see we have our two tables here, sales and weather. We want to link these two tables together. We want to relate them. We want to set up a relationship. Sales has date, weather has date. Now all of these sales are for one city, so we don't have a secondary key there to worry about. We could just let PowerPivot do this relating for us in the pivot table, but instead I'm going to explicitly create this. So I want to relate date in this table to date in the other table. I come here to the date header of the first table, we'll right click and say create relationship, and here we say we're going to go from sales, column date, and we want to go to weather. And because weather has something called date, it automatically fills that in for us. Just click create, and we now have a link between those two items. When we create the pivot table now, you'll see that we have all of the items from our sales table as well as the items from our weather table linked together without any hassles at all. So one of the great things about PowerPivot is the ability to take those two sheets that have a common key between them and link them up without any hassles. All right, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.